Hi, Bex here. I'm here to give you a brief overview of what Quotient has to offer. Let's see just how quick it is to send your first quote. Starting from the very beginning, we'll hit Start Trial. Enter your name, email and password, your company name, and hit Create Account. That's it. Your Quotient account is ready to go. You have 30 days to try out all the features of a paid account for free. Before getting started, you can tweak a few details here. We're going to upload our company logo now and add a company address and website. These details will display on our quotes. Everything here can be configured later in settings, so we'll save and get started. Right, this is your Quotient dashboard. There'll be more to see here over time, which we'll touch on later. We're going to go ahead and create our first new quote. We're going to start by entering the email address of our customer and create a new contact. We'll enter their name, and since we're making this quote out for a company, we'll add the company name in too. Click Create here, and there's our new contact added. Next, we'll add a title. We're providing catering for an event. We'll add a couple of price items with a title, description, unit price, and quantity. I also have some photos here from a similar event we've hosted recently, so let's add those now. These images will help give a good sense of the quality of our services at a glance. And a second item that just has a unit price, as quantity is an optional field. Next, let's add some text items for things that help reinforce what we're selling, why you might choose the River Kitchen, along with some guarantees that make our customer feel comfortable. Finally, we're going to add in some payment terms and conditions. Right, it's all looking pretty good, but before we preview the quote, I think this item here would be better as an introduction. It'll make a nice message before getting into the pricing details. To move this item up the top, I'll hit the up arrow. That looks better. The last tweak I want to make is on this item here. I remember now that I hadn't discussed this when meeting with the customer. I've popped it in as I thought it would be a helpful addition, but we don't want to force it on our customer. So we're going to make this item optional by hitting the cog icon and selecting optional item. This now means that the value of the item does not affect the quote total until the customer selects this item on their quote. So, we're happy with everything else. Let's save our work and see how our quote is looking before we send it. You can see the logo we uploaded earlier, our company details, address, and website. We can clearly see the customer we're sending our quote to and the date that the quote is valid until. We see all the items of our quote clearly laid out, our introduction and price items, images, which can be opened to view in more detail, and our optional item. You can see when selected, the total updates automatically. Right, before we send it to the customer, we have the option to preview the quote exactly as our customer will see it. We'll hit Preview and scroll down to see the difference. You can see the customer can ask a question. We have an acceptance form here, so when they feel comfortable with your offer, they can accept the quote or add some comments, maybe an order number, check the box to accept your terms, making the quote legally binding, and click to accept. So that's exactly what your customer will see, which gives you peace of mind. Let's switch back to our view. We're happy and feel comfortable with everything here, so let's hit send. You can view the email the customer is going to receive, and since I've just recently had a customer meeting, I'm going to add a quick message. It was nice meeting you this morning, and send. Now it's just a case of waiting and seeing what happens. With some far out internet magic, we can see here what things might look like in the future. And with a wave of my magic wand, we see the quote has been recently opened. And there's also a new question there. So let's scroll down and see. Scarlett asks, do you have a sample menu we can see? Let's reply, we sure do, here it is, as well as attaching the menu I have on file, and hit answer question. Great! Now Scarlett will also receive an email notification with our answer. I'm sure she'll be pleased with our prompt service, which will hopefully be enough encouragement for her to accept our quote. If we step forward into the future a little further, we see the quote has now been accepted. Both you and your customer receive an email notification, and we see here the status is now accepted. If we scroll down, we'll see a copy of the acceptance form with the date and time of the acceptance and any additional comments. The total has been confirmed, as well as any optional items which may or may not have been selected. There's also a digital fingerprint, which you can click into for more information. So that's how easy it is to quote right through to acceptance. We're now going to jump back to the Quotient dashboard. We see our one quote here that's been accepted, and we're starting to see some stats. As you continue to use Quotient, the information here will become more helpful over time. so we're going to use a little more magic and fast forward time by a few days to see how your dashboard may look. All right, so here we can see we've got a few more quotes. We've got two draft quotes in progress, other recently sent and recently accepted quotes appear here too. Our stats here show the ratio of accepted to awaiting acceptance over time, which is a really good indicator of how you're tracking. You'll see here, Quotient notifies you of quotes that need following up. This could be quotes that have been unopened after a certain amount of hours, or it may be quotes that have not been accepted after a certain amount of days. This way, you'll never forget to follow up, and it takes very little effort to send a follow-up email to your customers. Another really handy feature is we can search any previous quote by title, quote number, or customer. Up in this top banner, we can see we're currently on the dashboard. There's quotes, which is where you can filter and search by all your quotes, and contacts, which contains all your customer and company information. Next, you'll find templates and items where you can create a content template. Even if it's just a template that holds your terms and conditions, this can really save a lot of time when creating new quotes. In the top right corner here, we can find settings. To give you a quick overview, you can add a team member here, you can change the quote layout and alter colors, customer emails, where you can modify the email content for new and accepted quotes and follow-up emails. You can see add-ons, where you can find additional features and connect to other apps. You can also edit your profile here and upload a profile image if you'd like. Your profile image will show in the questions and answers on quotes. Finally, before we wrap up, if you want to know more about any of these things, you can find help by clicking on the top right here and hit help and support. You can shoot us a message and we'll get back to you as soon as possible, or you may help yourself if you wish by browsing or searching the help articles. So that's a really brief overview of what Quotient has to offer. I hope that helps make your journey with Quotient that much easier to get started. Best of luck in your business and happy quoting!